What are the salient findings and interpretation? At one look, it looks like a left bundle branch block with wide slurred QRS complexes in lead 1 and AVL. But V5 shows negative complexes, which is not typical of LBBB. There is left axis deviation as indicated by negative complexes in the inferior leads. PR interval can be seen as varying on scrutiny of multiple beats, but PP interval is constant. Atrial rate is higher than the ventricular rate, with PP interval shorter than RR interval. Hence, the four criteria for complete heart block are satisfied: regular PP interval, regular RR interval, totally varying PR interval, atrial rate higher than ventricular rate. But there is a catch here. It should be an infrahisian block as the QRS is wide. We would expect the ventricular escape rate to be around 40 per minute. But here it is 60 per minute. This should make us suspect that it is right ventricular apical pace rhythm in a person with complete heart block. Then where is the pacing artifact? It is hard to locate any pacing artifact even on close scrutiny. Look at the low pass filter setting, 40 Hz, at the bottom of the ECG. Pacing spike or artifact is a high frequency signal which needs a low pass filter setting of 100 Hz for detection. Here, since the low pass filter is set at 40 Hz, pacing signals are not displayed in the ECG. This is a common problem with digital ECGs. If the person or caregivers are not mentioning the presence of pacemaker when in an emergency department, it is easy to mistake the ECG for just left bundle branch block. Of course, a routine chest X-ray will very well show the pacemaker. Changing the low pass filter to 100 Hz or more will show the pacing artifacts well. An alternate option in most modern ECG machines and monitors is to switch on pacemaker detection, which will produce a very prominent pacing artifact in the tracing, often of very large amplitudes. In the upper tracing, pacing artifacts are hardly visible with low pass filter at 40 Hz. In the lower tracing, both atrial and ventricular pacing spikes are seen with low pass filter at 150 Hz. What are these high pass and low pass filters? Here the high pass filter is at 0.5 Hz. It means that only signals above this frequency level will be detected. This filter is meant to filter out the baseline fluctuation due to respiratory thoracic movements, which is in the low frequency range. A low pass filter is meant to filter out high frequency signals, mostly electromyographic in origin, which is of high frequency. In addition to this, a notch filter of 50 or 60 Hz to filter out line voltage alternating current interference is also routinely used. Switching off the line voltage filter often produces sine wave artifacts in the ECG baseline corresponding to the line voltage in use. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.